Sam Billings produced the innings of the Royal London One Day Cup competition, smashing an extraordinary undefeated 135 off only 58 balls, equaling the fastest ton of the summer, as Kent made it 2 wins out of 2 at the start of this year's exciting 50-over tournament, with a thrilling 2-run victory over Somerset in Taunton on the Duckworth-Lewis method, on a remarkable day in which 754 runs were scored. Marcus Trescothick's side had chased down 311 at this ground last weekend, and he fancied chasing again, so inserted Kent after winning the toss, the visiting side missing their captain Rob Key. Actually, they hardly missed him at all, as Daniel Bell Drummond and the acting captain Sam Northeast opened up with an exciting stand of 117 runs, which were made in the first 20 overs, a partnership filled with scorching stroke play from both on a pitch which was green-tinged but offered the bowlers very little. 58 runs came off the 10 overs of power play, and then Northeast drilled Tim Groenewald over the rope for the first 6 of the match in the 13th over. The 100 was up in the 15th, with Bell Drummond the first to his 50, his first in the one-day arena. It came off only 37 balls, that being his 9th 4. But shortly afterwards, he was unsure to stick or twist against Jack Leach and was stumped by Alex Sparrow on 61, but he had given his side a cracking start. Leach was playing in his first game of the summer and was the pick of the home attack. He also had Brendan Nash caught by Barrow off a glove sweep. Darren Stevens was out for a couple, Lewis Gregory having him caught in the covers by Alfonso Thomas, as Kent looked as if they weren't going to make the most of their start. They slipped to 165 for 4 in the 32nd over, when Fabian Cowdrey, who'd just been dropped, gave Leach his third scalp, Craig Overton holding on at mid-on. With 17 overs left, the visitors were on 166 for 5, Alex Blake edging Peter Trigo to Trescothick, but few could have been ready for what was to come. The batting power play was taken after 35 overs, and after nothing more than a steady start, Billings exploded into life. He took Groenewald for these 2 sixes, along with a couple of 4s in an over, which cost 22 runs, which helped the Spitfires get to 237 for 5 with 10 overs left. Billings' 64 was crucial in his side's win over Durham at the weekend, and he was at the half-century mark again, with this shot taking him there off only 25 deliveries. He'd thus far found the boundary 5 times and cleared it twice, but this was just the hors d'oeuvre. He was about to produce something rather special. He took full advantage of some over-pitching from the Somerset attack, Overton guilty here, as this ball was sent a long, long way. Billings took the headlines away from Northeast, hitting 77 runs of the 100-run partnership, which arrived off only 51 deliveries. But Northeast has to take an awful lot of credit for his knock. Next ball, he turned Trigo to fine leg to complete his own 100 off 115 balls. That was his 8th 4 to go with his early maximum. He was also fortunate enough to have the best seat in the house to watch the brilliant Billings at work. It was now utter mayhem in the middle. Northeast started hitting boundaries for fun, bringing up the 300 in the 45th over, while Billings raced into the 90s with a left-handed pull off Thomas that went for 6. In a remarkable 13 overs, these two had doubled the total, adding 167 runs before Northeast was at last out for a runnable 132, a career best as he holed out to James Hildreth. Billings then attacked Gregory. 3 more 4s came off successive balls as a young keeper, in the form of his life, reached an astonishing 100 off just 46 balls, equaling the fastest of the season with the one made against Kent by Middlesex's Dan Christian in the T20. The 23-year-old former England under-19 player had every right to celebrate in the manner he did. It was simply sensational. And he wasn't done yet either. Having kept the strike for the next over, he smashed this 6 and followed it up with 3 more 4s to move on to 122 from 52. He put on 35 in 2 overs with Callum Haggett, who was out for 1, caught on the long-on boundary by Colin Ingram off Thomas, who can rarely have been treated like this. James Treadwell came in and struck the seventh six of the innings to go with 42 fours, 17 of which were hit by Billings, who ended on 135 from 58 balls, as Kent made 383 for seven, just one shy of their best ever total in the one-day game. A brief shower during the break left Somerset a target of 374 off 48 overs at just less than 8 runs per over. And after 10 came off the first 3 balls, Triscothic edged Doug Bollinger to Treadwell. Needless to say, Somerset had to get off to a flyer, but in spite of these boundaries, they weren't able to make full use of the power play. Both Nick Compton and Trigo found the boundary from time to time, but after 10 overs, only 49 runs were on the board and the run rate required was already rising. Eventually, this pair added 78 runs together in 14 overs. An exceptional bit of fielding at mid-on from northeast then ran out Trigo for 38, just when he was set to let loose. Compton played his role well, making 56 off 59 balls, but then he lost his middle stump to Stevens. Before Hildreth was LBW to Treadwell, and Ingram was dismissed by Haggett to lead the home side out of it surely on 144 for 5. With 20 overs of the match remaining, the home side still needed 223. There was nothing to lose, so Gregory and Barrow played as freely as they could to take the total to 211 midway through the 34th over, 14 and a half to go in this slightly reduced match. Gregory had taken his side over the line against Durham at Taunton with an awesome 100, but here he was out for a 21-ball 35, bowled by a Turner from Cowdrey. Barrow was still there, however, and his 50 was completed off his 39th delivery, but with 10 overs of this wonderful game left, Somerset still required 109 runs to win. And Kent had surely done it when Overton swung Bollinger out to Cowdrey after making a rapid 36. Before 3 balls later, Barrow departed for 54 as he top-edged the Australian bowler to Haggett. So Somerset were on 268 for 8, needing 106 more runs from 54 balls with 2 new batsmen at the crease. Grunewald hadn't given up yet though, and he smashed his 3rd and 7th deliveries for 6s. Over the years, those lucky enough to watch their cricket in Taunton have seen some unbelievable performances, especially in the one-day format, but few would have expected Grunewald and Thomas to get their side anywhere close on this occasion. When they came together, they needed 12 runs off each over, and as we entered the last 4 overs, they'd done really well to prevent that rate from going above 14. Without the need for slogging, they somehow managed to keep their side in with a shout, and by the time the last over arrived, 13 more runs were wanted. Mitch Claydon had the honour of bowling it, and Thomas produced a stunning shot first ball to take the target to 9 off 5. A single followed, and then Grunewald got to his 50 with another boundary off his 25th delivery. He was left with 1 more 4 to get off the final ball, but could only manage a leg by. Wow, what a game, and Somerset may argue that if it hadn't been for that shower during the break, they would have won this extraordinary game of cricket. They ended on 371 for 8 from 48, Grunewald with 52 from 27 and Thomas 49 from 29. According to Duckworth and Lewis, they lost by only 2 runs. So it's 2 wins from 2 for Kent, who next head to the Oval to take on Surrey next Tuesday, while Somerset are at Warwickshire on the same day, both games under lights.